Good morning, everybody. Well, the sunshine and rising temps are providing much needed relief from the cold and wet weather, but those warmer winds are also ushering in allergy season. Pharmacist Victor Wong returns with helps to battle those allergy bugs, or whatever you want to call them. They certainly do bug us. Good morning. Good to see you.
Yes, nice seeing you.
I've been a long-time sufferer. We were just talking about that. So let's talk about the difference, first of all, between allergy symptoms or cold symptoms, because oftentimes people confuse the two.
Yeah, I mean, they're very similar. They all have the stuffy nose, the itchy eyes, the sneezing, the coughing. But uniquely, it's the amount of time that you spend with the symptoms that's the clear differentiator.
Okay.
I mean, colds last for 5 to 10 days. But with allergies, it can be weeks, months at a time. I mean, people are suffering for long periods of time.
And you're saying more and more people are developing allergies because of the warmer climates. Global warming might be the correlation or contributing to the increase?
Yeah, I mean, there's some sort of correlation. So this warmer weather that's lasting longer seems to correlate with people suffering more. So we find the rates going higher and higher. And even in the pharmacies, I see people coming in and they're feeling miserable. They can't sleep, they're sneezing. They're constantly under a fog all day.
You've got some great tips. First of all, you say if you're outside all day, as soon as you get inside, you should wash your face because all the pollen and stuff gets trapped on our eyelashes.
That's right. And not just the eyelashes too, but think about the hair. The hair is like a magnet for pollen, especially if you wear hair gel or hairspray. So you really want to wash it all off. And your clothes too. Take it off, rinse it, put it in the laundry, because you don't want to be bringing all that home. You want your home to be a sanctuary for you.
And your pets?
Your pets too, yeah. I mean, you know, Fido's out roaming around in the garden, you know, romping around, and they're carrying a lot of pollen when they come home. So give Fido a spray down too.
3 times a day? They're going to hate that. That's a lot of extra work, but I guess if you're suffering, and if you do notice these symptoms persist and they're quite severe, it can be debilitating. People make fun of it like, oh, big deal, you have allergies. It could feel like a cold and flu.
Right, and as you were saying, I mean, you may be a sufferer yourself. And I mean, it's terrible. It's hard to live a normal life and do normal activities if you're constantly sneezing and having itchy eyes and feeling under the weather.
So if we want to take something for it, what do you recommend and how often do we take it? Because I know you have to start taking it right away.
Yeah.
And be diligent.
That's right. I always recommend first step, select a good oral antihistamine, like Reactin.
Yeah.
Something that can last 24 hours a day. It's super safe and can offer multi-symptom relief. It can offer relief from that itchy eyes, sneezing, runny nose, congestion. A lot of people don't realize, but the best time to take it is before the symptoms start happening.
So it's like suntan lotion. You're supposed to put it on 25 to 35 minutes before, so same thing?
Exactly. Take it before you go outside. That way it prevents the symptoms from even happening.
So take it in the morning, like whatever, if you're having a smoothie or whatever your breakfast is almost like a vitamin, and then you're good for the day, but continue it, right?
Exactly.
So when you feel better, you say don't stop because it would return. It gets out of your system quickly.
That's right. Take it every single day, especially during the peak of allergy season. It's safe and really can make life easier to live, and you can enjoy all your normal activities like sitting on a patio.
And or ecotherapy, yes, because we all need to get outside more. We shouldn't be afraid of the great outdoors because it makes us feel sneezy and sickly.
I know, like this past weekend, so amazing.
So beautiful. And also, might I add from experience, if it gets to the point where it's debilitating every single day, you might have to go see an allergist.
Mm, yes.
And then they might have to give you injections or whatever because it's just you can't get through the day, even in wintertime, right?
Exactly.
It's
that's
dust
right.
molds. Thank you so much. So good to see you, Victor. And I appreciate your love for patios. For more information, head to our website, breakfasttelevision.ca. Duchess had a baby.